your app icons ready for the future of iOS? With iOS 26 and the upcoming wave of Apple Glass devices, a new visual paradigm is here, the liquid glass icon. These aren't your flat static images anymore, they're dynamically layered and react to light and depth, bringing a whole new level of polish to your app. For too long, creating advanced, multi-layered icons was a complex mess of different design tools, but Apple has reintroduced a fan favorite, the Icon Composer. This is how you can actually very simply create new layered Apple Glass designs. Now, this isn't something meant to completely replace design software, and I'm by no means a graphic designer, but using this tool with any assets is actually really easy to create those layered or 3D glass app icons. So today I'm going to show you how to use this powerful, updated tool to create stunning, future-proof app icons that will truly stand out. Let's go ahead and dive on in. Now there are a few prerequisites, and depending on when you're watching this video, some of these tools might be out of beta, but we will be using Icon Composer and Xcode 26 or later. So you'll need to navigate over to the developer.apple.com to the Icon Composer. I'll also have a link for everything that we're using today in the description below. So under the Develop tab, you'll want to first sign in and then head on over to the Downloads tab. From here, you'll want to go to the Applications in the top right, and you can either search or scroll. Now, as I mentioned, you will also need Xcode 26. So if it's still in beta, you may need to download it here instead of the App Store, and the Icon Composer beta. Currently, it's to number 3, and you can learn more and then go to the download button up here. It's actually a really quick download. Once it's downloaded, you'll need to install it onto your machine, and this is how we'll be taking our old icon. Here I have one for my app TapDuel, and I've given it this new liquid glass look. And don't worry, we'll be going over the steps of creating this. And you can see there's lots of different tools. We could even rotate and simulate how the light is reacting and reflecting on the liquid glass background. We can change the background color. We could even simulate how it might look on someone's, you know, background. Even if you want to add your own phone background here, you totally can. And there's also the default dark and mono colors as well. You can even include, you know, watchOS or iOS, macOS, etc. But it's actually really easy. And, you know, for someone who has a little bit of experience with Photoshop, it was really easy to make my new app icon. So let's take a look from a fresh project to see how we can create these. So I'd always recommend also just, you know, creating a new folder for all of your assets. Let's rename this folder to be, you know, let's say TapDuel new icon. You also want to put all of your different assets within this folder. So for me, I have the different assets for things like the hand, the, you know, press effects that we do have, as well as the text. Again, Icon Composer isn't something that's meant to completely replace design software, but rather just give you a way to add and layer different elements. So even if you're importing different images from the web or Procreate, or even just using Preview to remove the background, make sure you have those assets ready to go first. Okay, let's go ahead and open up Icon Composer, and we will be prompted to create a new document. So let's go ahead and create a new one here, and I'm just going to quickly save it into our new folder. So I'm going to save it into our folder on the desktop, which was the TapDuel new icon. And in terms of naming, I would refrain from calling this just app icon, because when we add it to Xcode later, I'm going to go ahead and call it TapDuel, or whatever the name of your app might be, app icon. Okay, so first things first, we do have a basic background and we are on the default setting. On the right side of the screen here, we can see that we can do an automatic background, we can do a solid, gradient, or even use the system light or system dark colors. For my app, I'm going to go ahead with a gradient, but of course you can choose whatever design best fits your app. For the colors, I'm going to be reusing the colors I had on my original PNG. So here I'm going to actually grab my eyedropper tool. If you want to open up the colors, you should be able to just click on the color option here. There are also, with this drop down here, some standard and recent colors. I like to just use the eyedropper. This way we can tab on over to our original image. I can grab that purple. And for the ending gradient, I'll select this other color. And let's grab that orangey color. Awesome. And we can see that we do have our gradient. We can even swap the colors if we'd like. Now, something I'd recommend doing if you are going to be including, you know, different things like dark mode in your app or how it reacts when the user is in dark mode, you can select that color. And I don't know why, sometimes you just have to give it a little quick refresh here in order for those colors to sync. But if you do want different colors, you can, of course, edit and adjust them here. You can even see if you want to be on dark mode. And then for the mono, I'm just going to leave this as gray for when people want those monotone app icons. Okay, a few other things to note. We do have this kind of radial kind of, I don't know what to call it, knob, I guess, where we can actually see and change how the light is reflecting on our app icon. Also, if you're like, wow, I don't want to use these default gradients, I love my background that I've created somewhere else, you can just add an image completely over top of this background. This is just something to make your life easier. Okay, let's go ahead and add a new group. And we're going to call this group, you can rename it by just clicking on it and waiting a second. Let's call it Tap Assets. So this is going to be a folder for our different, you know, assets that we're including. So for me, I have the hand, these kind of touch, you know, when you go to the pond and it like radiates out, ripple effect, I guess. And I also have the text that is exported as a PNG as well. So now that we have our group, we can press the plus icon down here and go to image, or we can navigate to our folder. We can then drag and drop our assets in. I would, you know, typically advise against doing this as it's a little bit easier to do it one by one and then also mess with the layers. So you can see here we've added our hand and we can actually drag this PNG around the screen as we see fit. We can also resize it. So we have the layout where you can actually put it to a precise, you know, location if you want it in a very specific spot, or you can just drag it around. So I'm gonna move it around and it looks like we're kind of a little bit off the center in our other app icon here. And for the percent, I'm actually just going to scroll it up, or you can just change the number. So if you want it to be 150%, that looks pretty accurate. You can also fill, again, a lot of my assets are white. So you can choose to do a solid fill. So if you want to change this hand to be like more of a blue or a yellow color, we totally could. There's even a gradient or automatic. There's also different blend modes and opacities that you can play around with. And if you really don't want the liquid glass at all, you can go ahead and remove it. You can also choose to vary it for the default mode or iOS or macOS. You can get as detailed for this as you'd like. I'm going to keep our hand as something that's not liquid glass, and we'll explore liquid glass for the other things. Also, it might be a little bit too big. Let's move this down to 125. Again, not a graphic designer, and this is more for example purposes. All right, let's go ahead and add our other elements. So I'm going to add next the gradient. And something to keep in mind is these are all things that are indeed layered. So you can get really creative with the layering of the apple glass as well, especially you can see here, if we zoom in a little bit, you can see that this asset kind of fades behind the other one with the glass effect on. So play around with these different things. I'm going to add our little tap. I'm just going to keep this as more of a reference photo. Okay, so we can maybe make it a little bit bigger. I'm going to leave the liquid glass on for this one. Great, and let's add the press next, which is this ripple effect. Perfect. And then finally our text of tap and dual. Let's go ahead and drag both of those in. Awesome. You'll notice even if I have the tap layer selected, I can't then move dual. Let's go ahead and change this. Let's make the dual a little bit more prominent down here. And let's select the tap again. And maybe we can make it a little bit bigger. It's a little bit small. I'm just doing my best. I'm doing my best and you know, going off of vibes. But you can see how by using these different layers and by customizing thing, you could even, you know, choose the glass. You can choose if things are visible or not, even if you're playing around with it and you're like, oh, does this layer look good here? But you can see how the new Apple Glass looks. I'll definitely need to fix this for watchOS because the L of Tap Dual is cut off. Let's move it over here. And let's say I'm happy with this design. We can go ahead and save our design with Command S to do it quickly, or you can go to the top, File, Save. And now, okay, I'm happy with how this looks. I want to go ahead and put this into Xcode. So we'll go up to the very top under Icon Composer File, and we're going to select Export, which you can also do with Shift Command E. So you can choose what platform you'd like, if you want the default appearance, you could even change the angle of the glass effect. Something I would recommend doing is also pressing this export all variants version. This is really handy for any different medias. So if we go ahead and add this to our folder here, might take a second. We now have all the different versions of PNGs, even if we have the tint version, if we have the monotone version, and these are all saved as PNGs. So this is good for, you know, your app store or any assets that you might be using for marketing. You kind of just have this app icon saved as a PNG. It is flattened, but it does have that Apple Glass look. You can also use this if you're, you know, launching on a device that's not an iOS 26 yet, so something previous, and you can just drag this app icon in. We now have our Tap Dual app icon, and this is the one that does have the file extension of icon. So you can see here, name and extension, Tap Dual app icon dot icon. So the next step is adding it to Xcode. So you are going to need 26 or higher. I'm going to go ahead and open up Tap Dual as a project here. And normally when we add app icons, we go to the assets, we go to the app icon and add it there. For the icon, we do have to do it a little bit differently. We're going to take our dot icon. So this is why I called it Tap Dual app icon. And we're going to instead drag it in the project navigator. This is where we have our other Swift files, you know, different folders, etc. Going to then add it. You even see open with Icon Composer, so if we do need to make edits or changes, we can actually just open it through here. The next step is we need to click on our Tap Dual top level file here, so the one that looks like the little App Store icon. Under the targets of Tap Dual, General, you'll need to scroll down a little bit here, and under App Icons in Launch Screen, might just need to expand it, you'll see here we have the app icon, and by default, this might be blank, or it might say app icon. We're gonna change it to be the new icon file that we've added. So that's Tap Dual app icon, or whatever you named yours. Also, very important, under the app icon source, ensure that this is checked. Include all app icon assets. Now, instead of grabbing the, you know, app icon from assets, it's going to look at our project file and it's going to say, okay, my app icon is this dot icon with liquid glass file. Now, when we run it on the simulator, or if you want to use a device, if you have iOS 26, we can go ahead and see the new app icon in action. So we can see here, it's loading in all the Apple Glass assets. Let's slide over. So we do, because we haven't loaded it yet, have our old icon. Once it launches, we'll come back to the home screen. Cool, and we can see that it has updated with the new Apple Glass icon. So it's now using that different App Dual icon that we composed with the icon composer. Definitely don't need to actually run the app right now. But now, hey, if I launch this on iOS 18, we're going to have the old app icon. That's why I suggested doing that export. Now we have the flattened version available for our app icon that we can use in the assets. So if we take this one that we exported, we change it to be our app icon. Oh, it's saying it's not the right size. Okay, we'll just quickly fix this real quick. Maybe I left it on like 50% or something. Let's open this with preview. Come on, Apple. You said it's 1024, but you're lying it's not 1024. Maybe you can fix this real quick in preview. Let's go ahead and resize it. So 1024. Perfect. And save that. Let's overwrite it. There we go. This is kind of future and backwards proof, past proof. I don't know what to really call that. So if we launch this on an iPhone, let's do 18.5 iOS. We'll have that flattened Apple Glass app icon as a backup, right? Because it'll say, oh, I can't run this new Apple Glass icon. I'm going to resort to the original app icon from Assets, which is this flattened PNG version. So I guess when you do export, maybe I'll edit that. So when you do export, I mean, it's easy to fix in preview. No, it was on size. Maybe we do the scale as times one. Maybe that'll fix it. I'm not sure. But again, you do need that 1024 by 1024, which is weird that it made it so large. Anyways, that's how you can future-proof, past-proof your app icons and create those, you know, app icons with the icon composer using the liquid glass technology. Again, I am not a graphic designer, but it is really fun to play around with the different layers, you know, having certain layers with Apple Glass, some without, to really give your app icons a new, fresh breath of life. So there we have it, the updated Apple Icon Composer combined with the power of Liquid Glass icons is a game changer for app design on Apple platforms. It simplifies a complex process, ensuring your app looks truly native, modern, and stands out on the home screen. If this video helped you understand and create those stunning new app icons, please smash that like button. And are you excited about this new Liquid Apple Glass revolution, whether it's through the user interface or for the app icons? What kind of dynamic effects will you create? Let me know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe for more practical dev tips, Swift UI insights, etc. Dream big, code bigger, and we'll see you in the next one. Have a great day!